Alright, I have not played this in a few days. Actually, when was the last time I played? Was it Saturday? No, that's a Tuesday. Tuesday night. Still, I left off at a place where I wanted more. So Westminster has been fully controlled by the Rooks. Now I need to find the remaining Helix glitches and these music boxes, aka the secrets of London. Don't need to be there, need to be in Westminster. Start. So the house is up there. Pretty sure. This video's telling me around here. So yes, I'm looking at a video. The reason why I'm doing that is because the geniuses at Ubisoft have taken it upon themselves to tell you, or to force you, to buy all of this stuff with real money. And I'm most certainly not doing that. So, what I have found thus far, which I found 25 of them, so there's 3 left. And there's no way in hell I'm gonna pay real money to get this, so. Looking up the rest on YouTube. Discovered, okay. This is going to be the annoying part. So I already got the vast majority of these, so now I think the ones left over is going to be an exercise of frustration.
Faster! Come on!
sure I've been here before, but... Yep, I've been here. All right. Next one. That's this area. Down in this island. Oh well. Couldn't be helped. Ah, yes, here's one. Perfect. All right, that's another one. So we're on the map here. Why does a boy run like he has a stick up his ass? It makes it so weird.
Passage with no passengers.
Right, this one's at Montago House. And there it is. All right. And is that a music box? Oh my god. Wow. Two birds at one stone. One more Helix glitch.
Faster! Slow down! Move it! Yeah!
Alright, so that's all the Helix glitches. Now on to the secrets of London. Making me work for all this. I can dictate which ones I want. Ones am I missing? 31. It's 31. So 31 is near this train station. That makes things easier. Thank you. I'm missing 1 and 4. So 4 will be up here. Somewhere in this area.
Is an expert shot.
So where's that big statue? So this big house. There it is. One more to go. Final music box. Got them all. Hey, what's up, guys? So sorry I did not see you. I was using my YouTube for something else, so I hope one of you is watching at least. Michael Fox on Nico. So, Nico, in case you were wondering, I'm actually playing this on PC with an Xbox One controller. So now, since I got this, let me go back to the vault and get my outfit. Put this game on, I got this guy's rig. It actually wouldn't play much better, to be honest. I mean, really, the only thing he'd have an advantage of for this game is the VRAM on his GPU. But his GPU's performance is pretty much on par with what I have, because I have a SLI. He has just one card, I have two. Again, Paul, his rig is great, but he only uses a 1080p monitor for now, so he's not really using the full extent of what the machine can do. Once he upgrades his monitor, he'll do really well. But he said himself, he's not much of a gamer. PC gamer, that is, so... trying to change him on that, because if he spent that much on a machine, he might as well get the enjoyment out of it. Alright, so now I can finally get that precursor outfit. It's a moment of truth. That lovely, lovely music. Alright, one more. Those are precursor robes.
I don't suppose they've got another suit back there, do you? That one looks a bit tight for me.
And you'd look a right tit in it.
Evie.
Look a right tit. Okay, so what perks does that outfit have? The Aegis. Could it be the garments of Minerva, a member of the first civilization? It is believed Minerva wore this protective outfit while in combat. There's a reason people believe she was the goddess of war. Decreased melee damage received by 10%. Decreased range damage received by 10%. Increased chainsaw damage by 10%. And I don't need that, I'm so leveled up. I still like the Eevee. Investigate a strange flower that has appeared in London.
Ah, my young friend. How good it is to see you. Fortunate, really. It would appear a highly toxic plant, which has the extraordinary effect of making people quite delirious, has been found in this very park. Yet, as far as modern science is aware, no such plant exists. I fear the good people of London might be in danger. Will you investigate?
Not your average flower. Mr. Darwin was right about these plants. Oh, I don't feel well.
Thank you. thinking, all right, Genie?
Okay. I'll gut you like a fish!
Oh, fuck it.
More to the bleep neck! She's good as dead! You won't be staring at me.
Okay. Look at it there.
Is everything all right?
That's one less to worry about.
My brother here. Rather pleasant out today, wouldn't you agree?
I suppose. I do with a bit of a change up, though.
Unlikely, I fear, with this being an island and all.
That's why I do so enjoy the continent. Far more variety. It excites the senses, I tell you.
Do you travel much, then?
Oh, this is no good, no good at all.
You're trippy. Hey, Dr. Pepper, what's going on? How are you doing? Seem to notice I'm doing the Charles Darwin stories now. I'm trying to knock those out. When I started earlier, I got all the remaining music boxes and the Helix glitches, as far as the story will let me. I believe there's some World War I stuff, but I haven't gotten around to that yet.
These footprints must belong to a rogue gardener.
Oh, Jason. Bring these back to Darwin, huh?
Easy. Move it! Come on! Move
it! Just started the World War I part. It's kind of interesting and different. Yeah, I don't know anything about it just from what the menus have said.
Easy, girl.
For what to drag it myself.
Well done. But you don't seem quite like yourself, if I may say so. It's just as I suspected. Those noxious fumes are not being released from the flowers, but from the pots. There must be something in there. An hallucinogenic concoction of some kind. Not unlike the soothing syrup, I should think. We must dispose of it, and quickly. I believe, my young friend, that I might know just the place. Who would want to poison the population of London? Who could devise such a nefarious plan? Obviously, it can't be Dr. Elliot's. So who can it be?
An organization my brother and I have been fighting all our lives. Dr. Elliot.
I'm afraid, my young friend, that some of your enemies want their toxin returned to them. Might I suggest you position our carriage directly in front of theirs? I believe the fumes will impair their ability to drive.
Right.
Destroy our cargo. We're almost there.
Here we go.
Move it! Come on! Come on! Calmly. There you go.
Fortunate indeed. Well, I'd better run now. You will take good care of yourself, won't you?
Oh, that was different. So what's the next one? Defamation. Okay, let's just get a drink. So on to the next Darwin story. Which way could it be that it is up here? Meters and change, so let me go on the streets, steal a carriage, try to make this not take forever to get there. It's all smoky in here, okay. Be a deer and fetch Darwin a newspaper. Oh, gotta chase somebody.
My young friend, today's papers carry a rebuttal of Mr. Owen's slanderous and ignorant remarks about my work. However, I'm feeling quite like a fossil today. Would you be a dear and get me a copy of the newspaper?
Oh, I'm coming to get you. Are you serious? Wow, okay. This just happened out of nowhere. Here. It's just people going both super fast and crazy for some reason.
Why have you attacked the newsboy?
A man paid me and my mates to force newsboys to display this leaflet. Yeah, take the bloody thing and leave me alone.
Mr. Darwin will want to hear about this.
Quick on the source of the anti-Darwin propaganda. I should just kill him for my troubles. Cruel caricature. Where is that? Last mission, it was so scripted that you're not allowed to catch the guy before you're supposed to, or else the game bugs out on you. That's great. Track down the source of anti-Darwin propaganda.
We are not apes. If the circumstances were not so grave, I'd compliment the artist on the wonderful caricature. They are fools if they believe they can stop progress by printing leaflets and killing newsboys. We must find out who is behind this propaganda before more innocents are harmed. I should very much like it if you could find and remove these awful things. Perhaps you can catch one of the bill posters red-handed.
What's happening over there?
This gets serious, isn't it?
This is a waste of paper if you ask me.
You think you can beat me?
Voices coming from here, but not there.
There's been a murder!
Sorry, buddy. So please blew up big time. Alright, so look at that. That's supposed to be a window. Well, you can tell it's just a black background with this little triangle shape. That's just lazy.
Come on!
Posters. I suppose these maps would be much harder if I didn't conquer them. But since I have, it makes things easier. I'm not as much opposition on them.
You! What do you think you're doing?
Darwin's theories. Darwin refused to cooperate with us. We wanted to recruit him, but he rebuffed all our offers. We've tried to intimidate him, blackmail him, but he's a stubborn old git.
I'm dismantling your propaganda press.
It's some sort of commotion.
Something strange going on.
What's all that?
Something's happening.
Isn't that odd?
What am I about to get myself into?
See what's going on here.
Need help surviving the streets? Look no further. I do hope you change your mind.
What the hell was that?
Sabotage all printers at once. Crafty. big line, pretty much. Should work. Okay, one more Darwin. Darwin. Not quite down here.
Hang on. Where's the rest?
Someone take the reins from that driver! I find an actual
get Darwin before it's too late.
Life's becoming a mess.
The unspeakable has happened. The police
are... Oh, Florence Nightingale, look at that.
Mr. Darwin and carried him away as if he were nothing but a common criminal. That policeman, he is corrupt to the bones, I'm sure of it. I do so fear for Mr. Darwin's safety.
Miss Nightingale, do you know where they might have gone?
The policeman, he did mention
I've never begged for anything before in my life.
I believe I know where it is. Follow me. Poor Mr. Darwin has been through so much recently. Those people are trying to discredit a lifetime of work. It's disgraceful. And I fear Mr. Darwin is no longer the fit young man who once traveled the world. Here we are. The obsequies are taking place here. I will wait here.
Shall he live? And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die.
Oh, I'm being attacked!
Quiet and
wait, what are you doing? Is this honestly what it feels like when I arrest someone? What do you want from me?
I need you to be honest with a friend of mine.
Oh, you're a brash one, aren't you?
Desperate times call for desperate measures.
Is there an exit?
For whether we live on... For whether we live unto the Lord. And whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we live, therefore, or die, we are the Lord's. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. Whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. For none of us liveth to himself, and no man dieth to himself. For whether we live unto
the Lord. Oh, is that an exit there? Please, let there be an exit.
We die unto the Lord. For whether we live unto the Lord. And whether we die, we die unto the Lord. Whether we live, therefore, or die, we are the Lord.
Don't worry, he'll be fine. What are those brigands up to now?
This is the culprit.
I was just carrying out my orders.
Oh, Lord! Please let me live!
Arresting an old man and dragging him off to Lord knows where is fine work indeed for a policeman. Now, sir, tell us where you have taken Mr. Darwin.
A man paid me to bring him to his secret base.
How terrible. We will need transportation.
He's very weak. We shouldn't move Mr. Darwin until I've seen to his wounds.
Please look after him, Miss Nightingale. My brother and I will visit soon.
Well, look who's here.
We're very worried about you, sir.
You're looking spry for a fossil, sir? A man's friends are the best measure of his worth. I'm proud to count you among mine.
The danger's past us. No need to leave, sir.
What Mr. Darwin needs now is rest. To that end, he's joining his family on the Isle of Wight.
Rest, indeed. I shall start work on my next book.
I must insist that you recuperate quietly, sir.
The acquisition of knowledge is in itself sufficiently recuperative. Go, tell her.
This is one fight I aim to avoid, sir.
Thank you for everything, my friends. Ideas, like people, can only thrive when they're free.
Well, how about that? That's it. For now, at least I can do the story. Lady with the lamp. Okay. She gave me a hug, it was cute.
His leg in bed 17 still complains of limb pain.
We've administered morphine.
So give him more.
Doctor, the patient is not terminal, and, well, too much could prove dangerous. I've seen it before. The patient falls asleep, only they never wake.
Give him another dose. I assure you, everything will be just fine. Yours are the only patients with complaints. Do you know why? Because the older nurses know their place and don't complicate caring for their patients with needless questions.
Yes, doctor.
Good. Now, what else have we got? I want all of these beds stripped with new bedding put on. We're expecting an influx of new patients from a boiler explosion.
But doctor, those beds are occupied. Where am I to put those people? Many are too ill to be moved.
Yes, well, I'll tell the orderly to bring up some more beds then. One last thing. Inform the other nurses that the morgue is strictly off limits from now on. Apparently, someone's been stealing body parts.
How ghastly, Doctor. Who would do such a thing?
I don't know, and I'm not willing to speculate. Still, keep your eyes open. There's a lot of cranks around here. Let's see now. All these patients, they also need to be moved. Where can we put them?
I believe there is room in the East Ward.
Excellent. I trust you will oversee the transfer? Nurse, I'd like to review your report.
As you wish, Doctor. I've had 8 patients today. You're short-staffed.
Let's start with this one. The man who lost his leg in bed 17 still complains of limb pain.
We've administered morphine.
So give him more.
Doctor, the patient is not terminal, and, well, too much could prove dangerous. I've seen it before. The patient falls asleep, only they never wake.
Give him another dose. I assure you, everything will be just fine. Yours are the only patients with complaints. Do you know why? Because the older nurses know their place and don't complicate caring for their patients with needless questions.
Yes, Doctor.
Good. Now, what else have we got? These are my orders for the day, nurse, so please pay attention. Firstly, make sure this ward is thoroughly clean
yes,
before
doctor.
You leave.
What is that?
They just noticed me now?
Bed six is a violent lunatic, so she may try to bite you when you give her her laudanum enema.
Yes, Doctor.
Have I forgotten anyone, hmm?
There's the patient in bed two.
Yes, what of him?
We've been unable to get him to take his lithium salts for 2 days.
Tie him down and force him. Get that ape of an orderly to help.
As you wish, Doctor.
Yes, I think that's just about it. One last thing. Inform the other nurses that the morgue is strictly off limits from now on. Apparently, someone's been stealing body parts.
How ghastly, Doctor. Who would do such a thing?
Evie visits Lambeth after Jacob's assassination of Dr. Elliotson.
Fry, what a pleasant surprise.
Hello, Clara. I was just going to check on Lambert since the asylum's closing. What brings you here?
The children in my care have been falling ill. Our usual tonics aren't working. A cane, too.
Are you certain you're feeling all right?
Of course. I am, miss.
Clara! Is there a doctor nearby? Bring her inside.
There's Nightingale again.
She simply collapsed?
Yes, she said the others took tonic, but it didn't work.
I should think not. Ever since Elliotson was murdered, the district has been overrun with counterfeit tonics. This one needs proper care. But without the appropriate medication, she and the others will quickly decline.
What do you need?
I need supplies. Plenty of them. And medicine. Some of the less common ingredients are being stolen and sold at auction.
I'd be happy to help.
Here's the list. Miss Fry. Evie Fry. I'm Miss Nightingale. How do you do? Please hurry. We don't have much time.
Not Clara.
That's it.
Will die if the asylum's not reached in time. It's grim.
Come on!
I can't thank you enough. These supplies are meant for Miss Nightingale.
I'm here to collect them.
And they're already loaded on the cart. Please take them.
Giddy up!
You mean that cart?
Yes.
Of course it is.
Please be careful. Some of those items are fragile.
Faster! Move it! Come on! Move it!
Not a moment too soon. I hope you brought the medication I requested.
How is she?
She will recover.
Babylon Ellie, the children.
Thanks to you, we can distribute authentic medicine now.
But is that a permanent solution?
I will petition to have regulations put in place.
Lambeth is in your debt.
It takes a long time to change things. But I'm not going anywhere, Miss Fry.
Alright, so I get beefed up medicine now. Room with a view. Where is that? Alright, let's try to take a carriage. Maybe closer to the Peace of Eden.
In an effort to ensure so great attraction.
So the hints you found in the Kenway House lead to the monument.
What a wonderful use of your time, following me around asking obvious questions.
Well, since Henry isn't here, I thought you might enjoy the company.
I don't require any company, and Mr. Green is following up on some leads of his own.
Oh yes, Mr. Green. That's a fascinating idea. Oh please, Mr. Green, come and take a look at this book and stand oh so close to me, Mr. Green.
I do not. Well, perhaps you have nothing better to do, but I'm busy protecting the assassins.
Are you really? What was it Father used to say?
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission.
Precisely. Anyway, I'm off. If I find any more wild geese for you to chase, I'll be in touch.
Be ever more pleasant for your absence.
Stop shouting. You are only being moved out of your homes if it is unsafe. Please show some respect for our guests. Our new proposal will ensure that these slums will be replaced with better, safer housing, sanitation facilities, and less open flame. What a racket! You sound like a bunch of children! You are being very ungrateful! Do you really want to keep living in fire traps? Well, we cannot continue this until you calm yourselves!
So how do I get there?
We are gathered here at the monument to the Great Fire in an effort to ensure so great a tragedy will never happen again. I would like to thank our esteemed guests, the Right Honorable Premier Disraeli, members of Parliament and others for being here today. Our proposed legislation will ensure that housing for the impoverished need not be a fire hazard. We have heard your concerns. There is no need for shouting. Please calm down. There's no need for all this disruption. Too many today live in what are little better than hovels, in crowded conditions near open flames, and with few methods of fire control. Will you please stop shouting? Safer housing, sanitation facilities, and less open flame. What a racket! You sound like a bunch of children! You are being very ungrateful! Well, we cannot continue this until you calm yourself. We We are gathered here at the monument to the Great Fire in an effort to ensure so great a tragedy will never happen again. I would like to thank our esteemed guests, the Right Honorable Premier Disraeli, members of Parliament and others for being here today. Our proposed legislation will ensure that housing for the impoverished need not be a fire hazard. We have heard your concerns. There is no need for shouting. Please calm down. There's no need for all this disruption. Too many today live in what are little better than hovels, in crowded conditions near open flame, and with few methods of fire control. Will you please stop shouting?
The crypts.
This looks familiar.
Here we go.
It's in the very top.
Vaults are always fun in Assassin's Creed.
The key to the vault, and the shroud.
So you can actually see the edge of the game map here.
Good day, Miss Fry. I'll take that.
You want the shroud to cement your own power. But what if you cannot control it?
And why do you want the shroud? Merely to keep the Templars from having it? How like an assassin. To hold the power of eternal life, and yet be too afraid to use it.
Eternal life? Is that what you think the shroud offers?
What I think is no longer your concern.
That was lame. I didn't see that coming. Come on. You're looking from time. Are you kidding me? Helix. Oh my god. Second hit comes out of nowhere, what the fuck? It's really weird.
NBC Safe Brooklyn 99.
You happy now?
Yeah, it's the best network on TV.
This should be fun.
Sir, the engine's just pulled into Waterloo. Once Stark's men arrive, they're gonna unload the train.
Well, not if the train has already left. Assemble a team at Charing Cross. I'll send the engines there for you to recover.
Central station's closed. Attaway's orders.
You saw these blueprints, did you not? Were you aware of this floor?
Punctual.
Once the order comes through, we will send you on your way to the central station. My colleague should be here shortly with the schedule for the central station. We thank you for your patience.
I need to get to the central station.
You and this whole lot. It won't happen until I have my train notices. Once the order comes through, we will send you on your way to the central station. My colleague should be here shortly with the schedule for the central station. We thank you for your patience.
Thank you, lad. Now help me up.
Have to run. Someone's bound to find you.
My colleague should be here shortly with the schedule for the... We thank you for your patience.
Mr. Fry, here's your sister. Still in the rally.
Here's your damn schedule.
Oh, I... Thank you. Attention, passengers. All trains are being diverted to Central Station. I repeat, make your way to Central Station for departures.
Get out of our way.
What's going on? The station chief is usually punctual.
Sir, I'm going to miss my train.
Thank you.
Perhaps I should thin this herd.
Not if I make an example of someone first. Such a glaring flaw as well.
Passenger. You
kill me, get on with this. I'll not cower.
Ah! running, I hope.
This is really dumb if that's a secret passage. It's so out of the way.
What a shame. Good partnerships are hard to come by.
Ours is most certainly dissolved.
It's business, Mr. Fry. One does what one must to come out on top. Crawford will not take the news of my death lightly. He can be unpleasant when he's cross. I have sacrificed so much. Want to lose my buses.
When coldness or deceit shall slight the beauty now they prize, and deem it but a faded light which beams within your eyes. When hollow hearts must wear a mask.
Mr. Starrick.
I told you not to disturb me!
Oh boy.
Till break your own to see. In such a moment I but ask that you remember me. That you remember me.
Crawford.
Her luster stripped by the hands of that savage. He must be brought to justice.
Pearl would not want justice. Pearl would want vengeance.
Your passion is most welcome, Miss Thorne. But we cannot let our emotions disrupt the lawful structures of society. If we do that, the enemy wins.
It shall happen in the shadows. Miss Fry will hang from the gallows, and I will flay her brother as he comes to save her.
I suppose it must be done. Take no chances. Increase the Templar presence in London. We alone protect this City of Light.
Yes, Crawford. And then we shall enter the vault and cast aside the shadows together.
A letter? For me?
Thank you.
What have we here?
Boiler, this Dredge character's meddling will be the death of us. He was loitering around the exchange today, asking far too many questions about the bank. Should he discover my plan, you will face a far worse fate than losing your job. Signed, Plutus.
So this Plutus is Starek's banker, hmm? I wager Dredge will lead me to him.
While you're out and about, do attempt not to destroy modern medicine or the London transportation network.
Don't make me laugh.
Innocent lives hang in the balance. They depend on this city.
I'm not the one who let Lucy Thorne walk away.
A mistake I intend to rectify immediately.
A letter? For me?
I thought I'd stop by for a visit, my lord. Do tell me of your adventures.
Jacob.
There he is.
Not much brass in our pockets. Check the ledger.
Thank you.
Your tongue out!
What do we have here?
What's that? Looks exciting.
Yeah. Yeah. Slow down now. Yeah. Easy does it.
Not a lesson.
Don't have to take this.
Please, allow me.
Get your revenge! everyday essentials right here. Just come talk to me. Look no further. Everyday wares.
That kind of thing makes me sick.
Get your everyday essentials. Come again now.
You ain't no
everything you need. That's a right here.
Cipher. Perhaps we have met before. Perhaps not. You search for an artifact. Let me show you the truth. Thank you.
hunt for one of my artifacts, but I come to you today to speak of the future. Follow Lydia Fry. She will lead you to me.
What's the position of the second wave?
1 hour away, at most.
Don't worry. It's just the generator acting up. I'll see to it.
That's not very polite.
Even in these trying times, we must never forget the laws of common courtesy. Arms down. We appear to have been following the same trail, Miss Fry.
I got here first.
Indeed, you are to be commended. I fear, however, that we have not wholly rooted out evil in this vicinity.
There's another radio.
Accompany me, if you would be so kind. Second device must be found, or new waves of zeppelins will soon blanket the heavens.
Short on soldiers, are we?
If you could put your considerable talents to good use at Tower Bridge, you would have the thanks of a brave but beleaguered nation.
I would settle for the right to vote.
We have word of further spires near Tower Bridge. If you can locate them, I have no doubt they'll have information on that second radio. Wherever these people are, trouble is sure to follow. Someone of your talents should have little difficulty in identifying them.
Thank you.
Come.
Thank you.
She eyed him from the coppers.
Thank you.
Huh.